the swelling that occurs, the fluid that occurs in the knee, what it's composed of depends on how long it's been there. Okay, the longer the swelling is in the knee, if you've ever noticed, you can push on someone's skin and it stays dipped. Those patients have a lot more protein in that fluid. And so what happens as you get that fluid, the joint has a structure that supports it, okay, the joint capsule, and it's like a balloon. So the more swelling that's in that knee, the tighter the balloon gets. Once that balloon gets too tight, you have a significant limit in how much you can move your knee. Okay, when that happens, you don't move your knee because it hurts, it's uncomfortable, so you keep it still. Keeping it still only creates kind of this vicious cycle of now it doesn't move, so I can have scar tissue start to set up. Anytime you put a joint, and as you get older, as we all do, you know, you put your body in a certain position and then you start to move out of that position and everything's like, oh, wait a minute, that doesn't feel so good. And that's also what's happening in a fresh knee joint, especially immediately following surgery. Those structures are not happy that they've been disturbed. They like to be where they are, they don't want to be cut, and that has all happened. And so the body's natural system says, I'm going to limit how much motion I want this knee to have, and so I'm going to send the swelling in.